let's just check this out real quick. I don't think I'm gonna get a location of Stonekeep here, but I'm pretty sure that if I right-click on the map, will I find Stonekeep? Let's see, Hammerfall. Okay, I'm right here, so... No, I actually need... Oh yeah, right here. That's right, I guess. And we have officially entered the dungeon. We think we are well equipped, so let's try this. I mean, so I actually even took a look at where I need to go. I mean, it's right here, somewhere around here, the Elder Scroll that we want, but I think I'm gonna explore the area and, you know, try and kill some goblins and see what loot I can find before we do that. Please welcome Stonekeep, surrender all weapons to the guards, for we are keepers. We are the keepers of peace. Really? I don't really know about that, mate. Alright, and the combat begins. Oh, skeevers. That took care of that. Does this rat have anything useful? Of course not. Okay, so let's see here. That was a different sound. I guess the... I guess there's a rat somewhere around me, trying to attack me. Oh yes, right there. Ah, how does that seal taste? So, I think I'm supposed to take a right from here. But, I mean, I could go here as well, so... I don't really know. Let's try and explore a little. Apparently, all these dungeons come with niches and crevices where you can actually like rest to keep like your health restored. So if you ever see one, it is highly recommended that you rest. And yeah, that's basically it. Just look at the expansive size of this map. It's huge. Well, I really doubt I'm gonna have much of a problem with, you know, with all the armor that I have on me. But if I do, then yeah, potions of healing should help. And would you look at that? Well, that takes care of you. Why is it that I only... Why is it that I'm only finding skewers here? Oh wait, let me just quickly mark the entry gate. I'm still pressing the shift even though it doesn't matter. So, this door opened, I guess we'll go ahead and search this. Look at this, look at this gorgeous loot right here. A dagger and some plate helm. That's good. I mean, I'll eventually have to start dropping stuff as and when, you know. Can I, like, pilfer this? No? Okay. Anyway. So, this is basically, I think, one of those places where I can actually, like, rest. It bit me! Oh, thank you. I think I'm gonna level up now. I mean, I did level up, but you get the point. Oh, wait. I think I should increase my will. Yeah, that's actually not vitality, that's willpower. And a little bit of endurance shouldn't hurt. And I think I'm gonna... Put this point into speed? Nah. I think I'm gonna put this point into agility. Okay. I mean, they don't really give you a lot of points. Look at this loot. Just look at it. 98 gold pieces. Talk about lucky. Yeah, I guess you can't really, you know. So I guess we'll just camp here for a while. Ooh, enemies are nearby. Show me. Where are they? Where are these enemies you speak of? Wait, somebody just attacked me. Nothing in here. We'll be getting out. Palace are lost. We are the last survivors of the court of Stonekeep. Are heading south through the goblin's caves. Nothing here either. So what is that? Whatever that was, it does not sound good. Oh my god. Like, is that a Minotaur? I don't want to die. I mean, I guess fleeing isn't exactly an option. I can't even hit this guy. I mean, my defense is coming along quite well, but... Hold up there, hold up. Finally. Yep, that was a Minotaur. I guess I'll just be resting here. Well, that went well. Stop dilly-dallying around and grab whatever we could and just get out of here. Man, that Minotaur guy was dangerous. So where did that thing open? I mean, these are just rats, so it doesn't really matter. I guess we'll try going through here. Are there wolves here? Shit. Can you die? I'm not even hitting that. Finally. Nothing usable. See, these are the kinds of enemies which I don't like. Wait, there are more? I suppose so. So it's basically just a side chamber of sorts, I guess. Goblins, finally. How does that feel? Look at this. They're all just dying, keeling over in one hit. See, that's what I like. That's what I like. Not, you know, swinging for 2 minutes straight and not getting a single hit. Yeah, I see a lot of goblins. Nothing usable. Let me just quickly, you know. But then again, these goblins have like really poor loot on them, so that's another thing. This. Nothing? I guess it's a statue of an eagle. I guess those sounds mean I'm going in the right direction. Wonder what that is. I mean, that's a new sound. That's a completely new sound. I haven't heard it before. Like, ever. So, wherever you are, you might as well, like, just show yourself, I guess. Oh yeah. That's a goblin right there. And more goblins. I guess I could call myself the Goblin Slayer now. Yeah, actually, like, trying to loot the goblins like this, that's pretty difficult to do, so... Nothing usable, alright. I am glad that I bought more than just one potion of health, because if I had just one potion, it will not have sufficed for this dungeon, especially with the way I'm, you know, exploring it, so... that sounds like a goblin. Where are you? Where are you? Nowhere to be seen. Now just need that pool drawer, and we'll be on our way then. Onwards. Nothing to fear from me. So I guess this is not the place to go then. Or is it? I mean, I can hear a goblin, but I can really see nobody, so... So, if you ever want to open the lock, what you've got to do is select it and pilfer it. Failure. Because I am a warrior, I've got like a 25% chance of successfully opening a lock. And in most cases, mission objectives aren't really, you know, hidden behind. Or another thing which I could do is just bash it with the sword. See? Just like that. Whoa, the guy just disappeared. Yeah, that's cool. So yeah, I mean, you can do that if you wanna take the like easy way, or if you like just wanna go the hard way, you can bash the doors. But whenever you're bashing the doors, just remember that it deals a lot of damage to your weapon, so you might wanna do that a little sparingly, or keep like a spear weapon. I think I'm gonna switch over to the katana and use the broadsword for bashing. So yeah, let's see what happens. I'm gonna increase the agility by a little, just so it's easier for me to hit these people. And I'm gonna put one to luck and put one to... Where do I put this? Speed? Persuasion? I guess persuasion. Yeah. Okay, so... Yeah, I can hear the sounds again, so I think I'm going the right way. I don't really know. Nothing usable. Okay. I suppose I can dig that. Oof, one hit and you're dead. Nothing usable. Let me just go ahead and switch up to the katana real quick. I mean, I don't really know what's like the better thing to... I'll just quickly mark this door. Yeah, that was a pool door, so... I heard some goblins somewhere. Here? Yeah, definitely. Man, that guy just disappeared. I don't know whether that's a glitch or... That is how it's supposed to happen. So I can't really tell the difference. This is still a one-hit kill with the katana, so nothing usable. Okay. I suppose there's no helping that. We can go up here, and I suppose we can take a rest if we want to until fully healed. There are enemies nearby. Oh, good job. Where are you, enemies? Come on. I would love to kill you with some playing. Oh my god. Oh, these are orcs. Not too difficult. 3-hit kills. So, I can't exactly see any raised platform of the nature. So here's the thing, I mean, in these games, these orcs are basically like the bad guys, like they are in Dungeons and Dragons, and in the later games, they're more like, you know, they're a breed of Mur. They're called the Orcimur. They were turned when, well, I think when Boethia ate some god and chat him out as Malakath. I'll need to read up on the exact details of the lore there. But yeah, basically when that god got turned, his followers also got turned into the Orcimur, which we know as the Orcs. As far as I know, correct me if I'm wrong though. Ooh, was that a 2-in-1? I think that was. That is so badass. Nothing usable. There's something scribbled on the walls there. And... I can't really tell which way I have to go, so... Map, please. Thank you. Apparently this place goes back there, so I don't know whether I want to go here or not. That place was a dead end, and the scroll is supposed to be somewhere over here, so... we can try going here. So these areas, like these gray areas, these are the resting niches as far as I can tell. Even in those games, even like in the first, very first dungeon escape which we did, these gray things would be the, you know, niches where you can actually like get up and rest. So I don't know about these though, I mean whether these are those same things. The king and the palace are lost. That's wait, that should lead me right back to the pool doors, so I guess I'll keep going through here. And I'm not exactly going to change levels in this walkthrough. Well, not walkthrough, I mean this playthrough. So, because I mean, I don't think I'm that fond of, you know, like... another goblin right here. Like just, let me just check him real quick if he has got some loot or something. And I think I spot another goblin right here. Yep, there we go. So these are what, this is basically what these buggers do. They will spot you first, and then they will follow you until the time that, you know, they are in numbers, and then they shall ambush you. So that's basically how they roll. So yeah, I'm not really that keen on exploring the dungeon. I am enjoying this part. I mean, it sort of grew on me over time. And oh no, that door just locked there. Nothing opened, anyway. So yeah, I mean, I don't really know. I'm not really going to explore so much, as in change entire levels and stuff. I'll just explore the first level, and hopefully we'll find our objective in that. Who whiffed at me? It was you. Thought as much. One strike. One hit. It's literally a one hit kill. I mean, when you play this mission and when you look back at the first level, you can clearly see the amount of difference that the first level had and this level which you're playing right now has. So, I mean, I don't exactly want to walk into another Minotaur, but as far as I'm getting goblins, I think I'm going in the right direction. But then again, I might be wrong. I mean, this place is supposed to be goblin infested. But yeah, I mean, the combat, once you escape the first dungeon, is just so much easier. And in the first dungeon, man, I mean, like, two or three goblins at once, they will slaughter you. Like, literally slaughter you like a pig. So... oh, a staff. Thank you. Another one. Yep, that's what they do. They lurk around the corner. And they wait for you to come, basically, you know. Swing. Yeah, so they basically wait for you to come about, or... well, they don't exactly wait for you to come about. If you walk into them, then you're basically forcing a confrontation. But usually what they do is they wait for a partner of theirs to come along. And once they do, they... oh my god, is that... yes, that is a human. Too bad I can't loot you. I mean, you don't exactly need the stuff you have right now, do you? That is an Orcimer. Where is Orcimer? Anyway. So yeah, I mean... I forgot what I was saying. Anyway, moving on. These are cheeky buggers. Did I come from this way? I don't remember. Let's just... oh shit! This was basically the last person that I wanted to see. But nice meeting you, I guess. Oh, that that went down much easier than I thought it would. Another one! Oh! But hey, I think the katana is like a much more superior weapon than the broadsword. I mean, it took him down in like just 3 hits. Hit, please. No, come here, come here, come here. I think the stone wall is stopping me from hitting you. Man, that was the first hit. And that was a staggering blow. And that was my last potion of healing. I think I really need to get out now and actually like buy more potions if I don't fail this time around, that is. Because I just can't seem to hit this guy. Whatever potion that is. Oh, that was another potion of healing. So I read it in the advice, like if you run out of potions, you really need to save your game or exit the dungeon ASAP. Like, save your game and exit the dungeon ASAP. Hit number 3, please. If you can, today, please. Finally. That was a little stressful, to be honest. Still can't take on goblins. So that puts me at level 6. 491 gold, that's quite a lot, I would say, yeah. Let's put that to speed so that we're more difficult to hit. And agility. Yeah, I think that's where I would like to distribute these points. I'll just keep it there and increase the agility more. So apparently what agility does is it lets you... Yeah, we're gonna follow this corridor and we're gonna exit through the pool door and just go back. So yeah, so what agility does is basically lets you... I already know that our objective wasn't this far into the wherever we're going, so I think it was in one of those earlier doors there. But I will come back here later after with some potions, so yeah. So anyway, so what agility does is it makes it easier for you to hit things, and what speed does is that it makes it difficult for others to hit you. So that's basically what we want. So when we see the low pass corridor to the left, we shall go there and we shall rest. Not rest, I mean, basically just go back. Whatever that is. So the third door, cool. What the hell is that? Is that a Tyrannosaurus Rex? Whew, shit. That went down quickly. Actually, no, that's an Argonian. Wait, the Argonians are bad guys in this? Lizard man. I mean, the lore for this game, compared to what it is right now, it was like severely underdeveloped back then. So yeah, I guess I can see how they would, you know, call these Argonians lizard men. So yeah, that was something. They also did like a very good job with the music and the background score and all of this game, because the game has like this tense feel to it, but it's all in 16-bit, not even in 16-bit, I mean it's in 32-bit, I guess. But they did like a really fine job with the music and stuff. I think that is the way we came from. And there are certain places where you, if you pass, you'll hear this music, like something, you know. Like drums. Oh wait, there's some goblins here. Let me just take care of them real quick. I see you, goblin. Come here so that I might kill you. Yeah. How does it feel to taste that steel, goblin? Thank you for that dagger. I shall make some profit of it. Where do we go now? Where do we go? Oh, oh shit. Not wolves. Not right now. I mean, wolves are the last thing we need right now. I think, no. I mean, where do I go, though? This place is a dead end. This place has nothing. Maybe this place has something, I don't know. Let's check. We'll actually check it the next time around that we come here. Holy shit, that's a huge wolf. See that one hit kill? The katana is like definitely a more superior weapon. Is that its tongue? Oh no, that's his blood. That looks funny right now, I mean, his tongue just sticking out like that. Yeah, so I'll just go back to Rihad real quick and... Whew. Man, that was something. Almost died. So, yeah, so, oh yeah, it's nighttime again. So, whenever it's nighttime, you always want to walk out with a weapon drawn. It's a much better idea in case you walk into thieves and stuff. So, yeah. So, I guess this is it for me this time around, and I'll be getting to other stuff soon, like making more of this soon, and until next time, catch you guys later. Farewell, fellow Earthlings. Take care.